Hello, my friends. So I hope you all are having an amazing day with the amazing blessings and with the amazing grace of God. My name is Dylan Sharon and welcome to another video. So today the title of my message will be God's incomparable and unending love. Yes, my friends, in today's video we will be going to be discussing about God's love. Amen. My friend, God's love is constant, consistent and steadfast. My friend, despite our continual flaws, sins and tendency to become distant from God, God's love draws us closer back to Him. Amen. My friend, in a world where giving and receiving love is often conditional and fleeting, God's love is stable, healing, comforting and a great source of refuge. Amen. My friend, the Bible reminds us about God's love in a greater way. My friend, when you need a reminder that God's love is a powerful presence in your life, just read the Bible. And it will greatly help you. Reading the Bible will greatly help you to understand about God's love for you. Amen. My friend, so here are some Bible verses that serve as confirmation. So my friends, without any further delay, let's get into them. My friend, the Gospel of John chapter 3 verse 16 says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not perish but have eternal life." My friend, this may be a very familiar Bible verse for many Christians. My friend, this Bible verse serves as a reminder that God's love is so deep that He gave up His only Son, Jesus Christ, on the cross so that we may have new life. Amen. My friend, through that sacrifice, we have received healing to our disease, forgiveness to our sins, and God has made us able to inherit eternal life. God made us able to inherit eternal life. Amen. My friend, God loves us with an everlasting love. God loves you with an everlasting love. Amen. Psalm 136 verse 26 says, "Give thanks to the God of heaven. His love endures forever." Amen. My friend, God's love endures forever. Give thanks to the God of heaven. Amen. Romans chapter 5 verse 8 says, "But God demonstrates His own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us." Amen. My friend, while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. My friend, through this, God demonstrates His own love for us. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Amen. 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 7 says, "Cast all your anxiety on Him because He cares for you." Amen. My friend, you need to cast all your anxiety on Him because He cares for you. You are able to cast all your anxiety on Him because He cares for you. God cares for you, my friends. Amen. Romans chapter 8 verse 39 says, "Neither height nor depth nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord." Amen. My friends, let us read from the verse 38. "For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord." Amen. My friend, nothing will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Lamentations 3 verse 22 says, "Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for His compassions never fail." Amen. My friend, because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for His compassions never fail. Amen. Isaiah chapter 54 verse 10 says, "Though the mountains be shaken and the hills be removed, yet my unfailing love for you will not be shaken." Amen. "Nor my covenant of peace be removed, says the Lord who has compassion on you." My friend, this is a very powerful Bible verse which mentions about the strength of God's love. Amen. 1 John chapter 4 verse 10 says, "This is love, not that we loved God, but that He loved us and sent His Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins." Amen. Zephaniah 3 verse 17 says, "The Lord your God is with you. He is mighty to save. He will take delight in you. He will quiet you with His love. He will rejoice over you with singing. Amen. My friend, the Lord your God is with you. He is mighty to save. He will take great delight in you. He will quiet you with His love. He will rejoice over you with singing. Amen. My friend, we will be going to end today's sermon by reading about love. We'll be going to be reading 1 Corinthians chapter 13 verse 4 to 8. 1 Corinthians chapter 13 verse 4 to 8 says, "Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails, but where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away." Amen. So my friends, I hope through reading all of these Bible verses, I hope you understood about God's unfailing and unending love, God's incomparable and unending love. My friend, so like this, there are many Bible verses in the Bible which mentions about God's love. Amen. So my friends, I hope everything is clear and coherent in today's video. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure to smash the thumbs up and don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you today, tomorrow and always. May God bless you and keep you. May God make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. Amen. Oh,